I timed this earlier. It's going to be less than 10 minutes, I promise. But I want to give you some background about PRRT before we jump in. So you can't really talk background without talking about my father. He was the founder and developer of PRRT. He started, graduated from UC San Francisco and went into the Navy as a physical therapist during the Vietnam War. After serving, yes, right, Richard? After serving, he went on to get his master's from USC with a specialty in musculoskeletal disorders and would become the director of the program for physical therapy assistants at San Diego City College. When he was practicing, he had 4 private practices. He would later sell 3 of them. He also was inventing a lot of products for pain relief. So one of his most popular ones was the Ab Circle Pro. It was originally called the Backercizer, developed for Backercizer after somebody would have back surgery. It was a rehab product that would be on the floor. He also has a pivotal therapy system, which is still available on Amazon today. He studied, in addition to physical therapy, he also studied chiropractic, where he went to as many chiropractic seminars as he could, looking for answers. He did osteopathy, acupuncture, massage, sports medicine, energetic psychology, and healing. The frustrations he found, limitations of all these techniques, he felt like there were weeks before improvement, if at all. There was no consistency with the improvements. He would have patients ask them, "Can you help me? How long is this going to take?" And he never felt like he could give them a straight answer. Unpredictable flare-ups, and oftentimes they would have results that wouldn't quite hold when they would leave. Another huge thing about PRRT is that you'll find that your patients and clients can't really direct you to the root cause of their symptoms. So we try to have global effects with our techniques and give you a system to be able to find the root causes, because patients can't always tell you this. They just say, "This is what hurts, now fix that," right? So one book that changed everything for him was The Integrative Action of the Nervous System by Sir Charles Sherrington. He was a British physiologist, and he studied on animals. He was studying the nervous system. And he is considered the founder of reciprocal inhibition and the birthplace of PNF concepts and terminology. He was doing studies on animals. That created a thought in Dad's head of, what if I could use this on my patients? What if primal reflexes might influence motor behavior, pain, trigger points, muscle spasm, restricted guarded joint motion? So what happens during reciprocal inhibition? Who's familiar? Everybody familiar with reciprocal inhibition? Raise your hand. Yes. So we have bicep, tricep, agonist, antagonist relationship, right? We have, if we're going to stimulate the bicep and the tricep's going to relax, what if we can use an additional stimulation to amplify the relaxation or the inhibition, right? So we're using reflexes to increase or amplify the results. Smooth movement execution, feedback mechanisms, it's all happening subconsciously through the central nervous system. You don't have to think about it. It's all a feedback loop. So if you've seen the calendar, we have 5 levels of training. This is not level specific, but I just wanted you to get a sense, because everybody kind of asked, like, is this myofascial? Is it cranial? Is it something that I'm familiar with? So we actually have stuff at all the levels that pull from different programs, and we integrate our own form of reflexes, which is reciprocal inhibition, cranial work, fascial work, emotional work, which is huge. We go into the startle reflex at level 2. We also have a sprinkling of lymphatics and visceral work. I had somebody look at the case studies that are available on our website on the research tab and give me some numbers. And they found 80% effective rate in painful conditions and a 67% effectiveness in reducing chronic pain symptoms. So with applying PRRT, tonight, this says, you know, in the future you'll learn, but tonight you're going to learn techniques that can cause changes in less than 30 seconds, lasting effective changes in less than 30 seconds. Implementation techniques are fun. Everybody loves techniques, right? That's why you're all here, probably, except for, you know, you came for the snacks, right? Yeah. I found that if you're not able to describe what you're about to do to your client, you're less likely to implement it. So if you can break it down to the simplest form of, I am finding a place of pain or dysfunction, and I'm going to use an opposing muscle. I'm going to stimulate an opposing muscle to have a relaxing effect on the area of pain or dysfunction. Okay, sound fun? Cool. Okay, objectives for tonight. Go through the core concepts. We already covered that. Cool, we're right on time. You're gonna learn 6 techniques that will give you rapid patient outcomes. And we are encouraging you to implement this as soon as possible. Use it tomorrow, use it on your wife. I mean.
I've got a client tomorrow, I've already got mine.
Cool, all right, yeah. We want, integrate it as soon as possible, promote patient-centered care. The awesome thing about PRRT, one of the awesome things, there's not just one, right, is that it blends seamlessly with anything you're already doing. You don't have to walk away from anything else you're finding successful. Work this in, find one of the techniques you resonate with from tonight, and try to work it in every day, almost every patient, if you can. And one of the things Dad always used to say is that you'll know right away whether it's going to help or not.